RAID storage, 40 gigabit lightning speed Thunderbolt 3 in a RAID container. This is one of the use cases I actually really like for Thunderbolt, but there's a little bit more to it. Let's take a look. So full disclosure, TerraMaster sent me two of these because I was asking some questions about it. And we're gonna give one away. Check this out. That's what you get in the box. TerraMaster security seal. So it doesn't look like much. Just external hard drive thing, but not an external hard drive thing because you can put two in here. And at the back, we've got Thunderbolt. Oh, we've also got network and USB, and we can daisy chain devices. And there's a power brick and some other accessories in here, screws, that kind of thing. Don't worry, I'm not gonna lose those when you get yours in the giveaway. So the idea with this is that you get some big hard drives and you put them in here, and then you can configure this thing if you wanna do RAID 1, RAID 0, or whatever. But there's no, you know, web GUI, there's no insane thing that you have to deal with. You can just turn this little control thing and be good to go. Now what I like about this is that you can use it kind of sort of as a Thunderbolt dock. Okay, a Thunderbolt dock that doesn't supply power, but a Thunderbolt dock nevertheless. Because we do have a LAN connection and we do have a reset cable and we do have some other stuff. So if you're gonna run a single hard drive, you can let it sit on single. If you're, you know, a crazy person and you just want a RAID 0 array and you're doing something for backups, you can do that. But RAID 1 is the one for mirroring. You're guarding against mechanical failure. I mean, think about the Rube Goldberg machine that is a mechanical hard drive. We've got neodymium magnets and electromagnetic coils and ceramic and probably heat-assisted magnetic recording and, you know, the spinning motor is manufactured with just insane aerospace tolerances, and you know, a speck of dust inside the drive can completely ruin your day. And yet we're able to reliably mass produce these? What sort of crazy universe is this? When you think about the bit density and all of the other stuff that goes with that to store 10 terabytes plus 20 terabytes, we're approaching 25 terabytes on a regular old pedestrian 3.5-inch mechanical hard drive. That's an absurd amount of information to be stored by such a ridiculous storage mechanism. I mean, think about how insane, it's just, oh, there's a mechanical head that moves back and forth and finds tracks and then reads information magnetically encoded on a platter of rust, basically. So if you wanna win one, all you gotta do is answer the question below, come to the Level 1 forum so I can find you, and answer the question, what would you do with it if you won one of these? And we're gonna pick at random. That's it. That's pretty much all there is to it. I love this kind of appliance technology because there's not really a lot to go wrong with it. There's not software, there's not really like the threat of it being exposed to the internet. There's not really anything to worry about. It's basically plug and play. You put in a hard drive or two, decide what mode you want it in with the control thing, plug it in with Thunderbolt, and you're good to go. And in case you're wondering, how do you test that? How do you make sure it's not gonna overheat or do anything weird? Well, you write, you know, 500 terabytes through it overnight. Well, not overnight, over a period of several nights, through a couple special devices and see if it dies, see if it overheats. And it did not. You know, depending on how fast your mechanical hard drives are, this thing can clear up to 300 megabytes per second, no problem. The interface speed really is 40 gigabit. So even if you're using, you know, big capacity flash drives, this thing is able to keep up with, you know, 500 megabytes per second plus from each drive, which will be your interface speed limitation for that. So, nice job, TerraMaster. One other thing worth noting is that it does actually come with a reasonable Thunderbolt 3 cable. It's just about 0.75 meters, give or take. Honestly, the only improvement that I can think of for this would have been if the trays were toolless. You still gotta use screws for holding it in. Toolless trays wouldn't have been that much more expensive, or make the overall design completely trayless so that you could, you know, hot swap mechanical drives and have a stack of mechanical drives somewhere else if you wanted to deal with it that way. Although in a RAID configuration, that doesn't really help you. Like, the way to use this is with the RAID 1 config. So, if you're searching for this on Amazon or somewhere like that, this is the TerraMaster TD2, also known as the RAID storage server, model number D2 on the bottom. But on the box, it's TD2 because two drives. I'm Mortal, this is Level 1. This has been a quick look at the Terra Master Raid NAS. It's linked below. Thanks to Terra Master for sending this over. And we're giving one away. So join us in the Level 1 forums, and I'll see you there.